In question number 16, two particles A and B are executing SHM with same amplitude A naught and time period T naught about the same mean position O. At t is equal to 0, particles are at distance A naught by 2 and root 3 A naught by 2 respectively from mean position, and both are moving in the same direction as shown. We have to match here the situation given in column 1 with the answers given in column 2. Well, I'll have a bit of explanation. Let's say this one is the mean position, and if when the particle R at this mean position and going along the direction, if I take that particular situation to be of zero phase, then position of particle 2, it is, I'm writing it down as x2, has to be written down as A naught sine omega t. And well, particle has traveled this much of the distance and is at root 3 A naught by 2 and moving towards the origin. So the phase would be pi minus pi by 3, or I would say it is 2 pi by 3. Similarly, for the particle A, it is at half the amplitude here and moving along negative direction. So it has to be written down as x1 is equal to A naught sine omega t plus pi plus pi by 6, that will be 7 pi by 6. Corresponding phasor diagram, I would say, if let's say this is representation of zero phase, this is x2 at 2 pi by 3, that means this angle being 60 degree, this is the value of A naught here, this angle is 120, and x1 is 7 pi by 6, this is pi, and here it is, this is 30 degree, this is the value of x1, I would say. Fine. Now let's take on to the questions here. Particle reach at their mean position as t is equal to t naught, then t naught divided by capital T naught can be. Capital T naught is the time period. For the particle B, I would say it is at root 3 A naught by 2. So it will travel a phase of pi by 3, then it will come to mean position. So that means omega T naught must be equal to pi by 3. Okay. And what about the omega here? T naught will be pi by 3, it is 2 pi by t naught here. So this one will cancel out. It is coming out to be capital T naught divided by 6. So its ratio would be 1 by 6. So definitely S will be the matching answer with A. What about the another part? For particle A, it is at the phase of pi by 6 in negative direction. So it will travel a phase from here to here, pi by 3 and then pi by 2. So total phase shifting it will have, that is 5 pi by 6. So I would say for the particle A, it is omega T naught will be equal to 5 pi by 6. So T naught will be how much? 5 pi by 6, and omega is 2 pi, here it is T naught. So this one, it is coming out to be small T naught divided by capital T naught, that is 5 divided by 12. So Q is also the correct matching, that is corresponding to particle A. So Q and S is the matching for the option A here. Now in option B, maximum separation between the particle is X naught. The maximum separation, how it will be varying? In fact, we can proceed with the calculation of the distance, or in fact the difference of the position of these two particle itself, that will be X1 minus X2. Looking on to the situation here, it is very much clear that this is the phases of X1 and X2 here. So X1 minus X2 will be somewhere around here. This is A0, this is A0. So this distance will be A0 root 2. Well, this is sine omega t. And what about this phase here? It is already pi. This one is 30 degree and this one is 45 degree. Okay, so I would say the total phase would be pi plus pi by 6 plus pi by 4. It is pi plus pi by 6 plus pi by 4. Have this value here. It is 12 LCM here. 12 plus 2 and plus 3. That is coming out to be 17 pi by 12. So it is plus 17 pi by 12. I will use this answer in the later stage. Okay, this is the difference of the position. So effectively maximum separation, when this equation shall attain the maximum value, that means definitely it will have the 1. So a naught root 2 is the maximum separation between the particles. So the value of x naught divided by 6 a naught will be root 2 divided by 6, or effectively 3 root 2. So it will be matching with p. What about c? Phase difference between the particle is phi. Then phi by 2 pi, we already had the phase difference between the particle in this particular situation itself, and here also. This is the phase of the particle B, and this is the phase of particle A. This angle is 60, this angle is 30. Altogether is 90 degree, or we may say it is pi by 2. So this equation, phi is pi by 2 divided by 2 pi, that means pi by 2, 2 pi, that is coming out to be 1 by 4. So T is the correct matching here. Both are at same position at T is equal to T1, then T1 divided by T0. Same position means the difference between the separation will become how much? 0. Look at the phases here. This portion, omega t plus 17 pi by 12, at t is equal to 0, already the phase is 17 pi by 12. That means when omega t plus 17 pi by 12 will now become 2 pi, at that instant the particle will be at the same position. So simply I would say it is omega t1 plus 17 pi by 12 will be equal to how much? 2 pi, or omega t1 will be equal to 24 minus 17. How much it is? It is 7 pi by 12. That means T1 divided by T0 is, omega I'll replace it by 2 pi by T0 into T1 is equal to 7 pi by 12. Or pi will cancel out. So T1 divided by T0 will be 7 divided by 24. So it is R. So as the answer, what we got here, A will be matching with Q and S, B will be matching with P, C will be matching with T, and D will be matching with R. That's the answer for question number 16. Now we shall proceed to question number 17. Here in question number 17, two ends A and B of rod AB are maintained at temperature 100 degrees Celsius and 0 degrees Celsius respectively. Thermal conductivity K of the rod is mentioned in the column 1. Different properties related to the conduction are mentioned in column 2. Match the entries in column 1 with the entries in column 2. Well, in the first case, the conductor is uniform and the conductivity also is constant. So in that case, the heat current, definitely I would say dq by dt would be equal to k into A into temperature gradient. That will remain constant throughout the region, and temperature gradient will also remain constant. So I would say the temperature at midpoint of the rod would definitely be 50 degrees Celsius. That means this will be matching with P. Temperature gradient will remain constant throughout the region. Okay, so A will be matching with P only. Now looking into the B here, from this end A to B, actually the area is increasing and the K is constant. That means on this part the total heat current flowing across the region remains constant. So what we can say, if area increases, that means dT by dx, that is the temperature gradient, it must decrease from A to B. So I would say temperature gradient decreases with x. That means T will be the correct match for option B. Other part is, what about the temperature at the midpoint? Definitely this is the heat current flowing and thermal resistance is higher on leftward side. So the total temperature difference will be higher from end A to the midpoint, or that means the temperature decrement will be on the higher side. So definitely at the midpoint the temperature would be less than 50 degrees Celsius. So this one will also be matching with R. Now in option C here, from end A to B, the resistance is actually increasing. So with the same argument as I gave for the matching here with the option B, I would say at the midpoint, the temperature will be more than 50 degrees Celsius. That means it will be matching with Q here. And what about the temperature gradient? As from A to B, the heat current remains same. area is decreasing, so dt by dx will be increasing. So temperature gradient increases with x, it will be Qs. And on this side, this time area remains constant but K is increasing. So altogether the total heat current will remain same. So that means for increasing K, we shall have dt by dx that will be decreasing. So I would say it will be matching with T here. And as we found that on the later stage, the conductivity is higher, or effectively the resistance is lower. So from end A to midpoint, the total temperature drop will be relatively on the higher side. So I would say temperature at midpoint is actually less than 50 degree. So this one will be matching with R and T. So here for the question number 17, we got the answer as A will be matching with P, B will be matching with R and T, C will be matching with Q and S, and D will be matching with R and T. So now we shall proceed to question number 18.